Back with a couple more auction pickups that I scored recently, and mostly old U.S. coinage or silver, foreign silver. I knew that there was mostly not silver in here, but there's some. It just says 60-piece coin lot, including large cent, FE cent, 2-cent, 3-cent, shield nickel, dimes, seated dimes, mostly low-grade hold or otherwise, but it is a lot of coins. The next thing I got, I believe, is foreign silver, mostly. And again, a couple error coins, maybe, U.S. error coins that I got at, a really good price. Nobody was bidding on them, so some cool things here, actually. There's, I got about 6 2-real coins and a 4-real coin, and then some crowns and things like that. I love doing business when it doesn't charge me a lot for shipping. Always package is really good, and I don't get much of what I bid on. I bid on a lot of stuff at his auctions. It's sort of fallen out here. But you can see the kind of stuff I'm able to pick up. I mean, a 4-real, 90% silver. That thing is really cool. And I'm not sure we got a date that's visible. I will try to magnify and see if I can come up with one. But, oh yeah, I can come up with one. This is 1840. 49 or 79. I'm going to have to look under microscope magnification, but a lot of really cool things. That is a silver Saudi Arabian coin. Pretty worn, but it's a lot of silver. And nobody else was putting a bid in on it, so I did. Really cool. These are Spanish minted in Mexico, 2 reals. And there's 2 of them in there. I might be able to make out a date on there. Kind of looks like you can't based on the way they have it numbered, but we'll see. Double clipped planchet nickel from 64. More error cents. There's a Newfoundland 20 cent piece from 1899. That thing's pretty cool. Silver coin. I think that's sterling, if I'm not mistaken. It's pre 80% Canadian stuff. And guys, this is really, the kind of stuff I go after. These are U.S. and error type coins. These are not. These are crowns. So there's all my silver. There's all my errors. A few bucks on this auction. Not a whole lot. Here's 4 more reals. 1870. Zacatecas mint. 90% silver. 2 reals. 1870. That's an old coin. And then 10 items. 10 more items here. And all of them are foreign silver, I believe. There might be one that's not. Let's see here. There's 10 centavos, Chilean. That may not be silver, actually. But it's still a cool coin. That's silver. It's a 20 cent Filipino from 44. There's still some more silver. 10 cent piece, 49 10 cent piece from Canada. Here's another Saudi Arabian quarter real. Some cool old coins here. Silver shilling from 43. Australian shilling with the ram head on the front. That thing is pretty cool. Pretty neat. Here's a 43 3-pence. Common silver coinage. A 22 1-peso. So here we go. Mike GPO's building a collection of these. I wonder if he's got a 22. I'll have to ask him. I think they're really cool. Here's a 54 5-franc. So there's a good amount of silver in that. Silver Australian 1937 1-crown. There you go. The last of the foreign silver coinage for me on this particular pickup. But pretty neat nonetheless. Add a bunch of foreign silver to the lot. Some errors, which I do collect, and certain ones. And everything I've got's for sale. So I post a lot of this stuff up. And if I can't, I keep them in my collection. I think they're kind of cool. Here's this bag of 60 or so coins. Some really, really, I mean, that is, it's got some edge damage and stuff, but like, guys, how much is that large cent worth? 1826 Liberty. It's not in great condition. It's all dinged up, but I mean, it's, everything's pretty visible. It's not super worn, right? That Saves from America, 1 cent. Here's another one from, I want to say 1820. It's sort of, maybe 1830. Another large cent from 1830. Worn date, but still pretty neat. Here's another one. Worn date, 1820 something, 1 cent. Kind of cool. That one's actually kind of nice. 1854. It's been soldered on the back. Look at that. I mean, it's a really nice example. Look at that one, guys. You're like, wow, that thing's amazing. That's in great shape. Boom. I wonder if you heat that up a little bit, if you could get that off without... I don't know if it's worth the effort, actually. And in this package, I think I got some more of what you see here. I got some friends that were hitting me up in the community for large cents and had recently got some of these type of things at auction. And so I'm adding to that with some right here. Honey and Hive. And that's Florida Today News. So pretty cool. Some fire starter. So these guys were holding on to stuff for me until I bought something from them again, and I did so. I guess I won this for a dollar. So they were holding on to this for me. I don't even know why I bid on this thing, but it's cool. Throw it in the collection. So there was some of these. These are just a mixture of old U.S. So, you know, we've got, let's see what we've got here. We've got cents. 5 cent, large cent, 2 cent, large cent here, shield nickel here, large cent, 2 cent, large cent. Here's a silver dime, it looks like. Here is a 58 Flying Eagle. There's a 3 cent piece right here. Kind of looks like a gold coin. Looks like it might have like a finish on it, and it's kind of chewed up at the bottom. And there's another nickel and a couple other large cents. So some cool coins. I'll be looking at dates, seeing if there's anything in there that stands out. But you know, just kind of a cool pickup of 20 or so coins. Couldn't really see this one too well in the picture. Obviously a 3 cent nickel. Indeed, a 3 cent nickel. Pretty cool additions. Let's see. Looks like 70 Austria, 3 large cents, and a Portugal, 50 Escudo. So there is a 50 Escudo Portuguese, Republic of Portugal, 50 Escudo, Austria, 50 shilling proof from 1970. And this is a 72 Portugal 50. So I think both of these have some silver content, about 60%. And then there's these three, which is kind of crazy the way they taped these coins up. But, you know, it kind of shows you what you're dealing with, right? You buy these things at auction. They have no idea what they're doing. They're like estate sale people. So they put tape, masking tape, around the coins and put them in an envelope. Let me get that thing under magnification. So there's one of each. So there's no date on this one, but that is like the maiden head. Then you have the flowing hair, which almost has a visible date. I mean, this one's going to be so chewed up, you're not going to be able to see the date. But anyhow, tell me what you think down below, guys. Be sure to post your comments. Give me a thumbs up if you like this. Be sure to subscribe and hit the bell so you get notified when I post up my next video. And until next time, then thanks for tuning in. This is Value Hunter, and I'm signing out.